A Pulse Asia survey shows a double-digit drop in the trust and approval ratings of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. The president's performance rating slipped to a score of 55. That's down 13 points from his score of 68 in December 2023. His trust rating also slid 16 points to 57%. It was 73% in December. Like Marcos, the rating of Vice President Sara Duterte also dipped. Her approval ranking sank by 7 points, sliding down to 67 from 74. Her trust rating dipped to 71 from 78. The survey was done from March 6 to 10. Another Pulse Asia survey, meanwhile, shows Vice President Sara Duterte in a statistically tie with Senator Raffy Tufo as the top presidential preferences for Filipinos for 2028. The Pulse Asia survey shows 35% of respondents would vote for Tufo as president. 34% opted to vote for Duterte. Other potential bets included in this survey are former Vice President Leni Robredo, the president's sister, Senator Aimee Marcos, and House Speaker Martin Romualdez. Meanwhile, Senator Grace Poe topped the vice presidential preferences at 35%. The survey was conducted from March 6 to 10 among 1,200 respondents nationwide. Iran vows revenge for an Israeli strike that killed two generals and five military advisors at its embassy compound in Damascus. The strike marked one of the most significant attacks yet on Iranian interests in Syria, where Israel has stepped up a long-running military campaign on Tehran and the groups it supports. Israel has not claimed responsibility for the attack, which destroyed a consular building adjacent to the main embassy complex. Until now, Iran has avoided directly entering the fray while supporting its allies' attacks on Israeli and U.S. targets. Tehran's threat raises the risk of further escalation of conflict in the Middle East. The United States warns Iran not to retaliate against it for the embassy compound attack in Syria. The U.S. has told the U.N. Security Council it had no prior warning of the strike. Iran, meanwhile, told the body it reserves the right to take a decisive response to the attack, accusing Israel of violating the U.N. Charter and international law.
We will not hesitate to defend our personnel and repeat our prior warnings to Iran and its proxies not to take advantage of the situation. Again, an attack in which we had no involvement or advanced knowledge to resume their attacks on U.S. personnel.
Iran reserves its legitimate and inherent right under international law and the United Nations Charter to take a decisive response to such reprehensible acts. Madam President, the representative of the United States and United Kingdom once again tried to deny its responsibility for the current situation in Syria and broad region by falsely blaming Iran. Iran strongly rejects these allegations. Iran is never seeking to contribute to the spillover of the conflict in the region, nor does it to escalate or spread the tension to the entire region.
The Pentagon also denies any prior knowledge or U.S. involvement in the embassy compound attack.
Well, we've made it very clear in private channels to Iran that we were not responsible for the strike that happened in Damascus. I will reiterate, the U.S. had no involvement in that strike, and we had no knowledge about it ahead of time. So I'll just leave it at that.
Attacks by Iran-backed proxies against U.S. troops based in Iraq and Syria stepped in February after Washington retaliated for the killing of three U.S. troops in Jordan. UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres, meanwhile, condemning the attack on Iran's diplomatic premises in Damascus. Guterres calls on all concerned parties to exercise the utmost restraint to avoid further escalation.
He reaffirms that the principle of inviolability of diplomatic and consular premises and personnel must be respected in all cases in accordance with international law. He cautions that any miscalculation could lead to a broader conflict in an already volatile region with devastating consequences for civilians who already are seeing unprecedented suffering in Syria, in Lebanon, the occupied Palestinian territory, and the broader Middle East.
Seven aid workers, including foreign nationals from the charity group World Central Kitchen, killed in an Israeli airstrike. The group says its aid workers were delivering food to starving civilians in Gaza when the attack happened. Those killed include an American Canadian, as well as some from Australia, Poland, and the UK. UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres slams the latest civilian attack, calling it unconscionable.
This is unconscionable, but it is an inevitable result of the way the war is being conducted. It demonstrates yet again the urgent need for an immediate humanitarian ceasefire, the unconditional release of all hostages, and the expansion of humanitarian aid into Gaza, as the Security Council demanded in its resolution last week. The resolution must be implemented without delay.
Israel vows to investigate the incident. Over 190 humanitarian workers have been killed since the war began last October 7.